When our daughter Alexandra was a little toddler, barely able to speak, one of the first things she learned to say was, "Baby up." She'd come up to me, hit my pant leg, "Baby up." That meant she wanted to be picked up. I'd carry her everywhere, so proud of her. I'd carry her in my arms, carry her on my shoulders. She'd ride piggyback. She loved being in her father's arms. Well, she's 23 years old now. I don't carry her quite as much, but God is not like us. He said in Isaiah, "Even to your old age, I am He who will sustain you. I have made you and I will carry you." You never get too old for God to carry you. As much as you love carrying your small children, holding them, protecting them, making sure they feel safe and secure, your Heavenly Father loves carrying you. When you're tempted to worry, feel overwhelmed, "Joel, I don't think I can make it through this sickness. How can I make it through this loss? These people at work are not fair." Instead of worrying, just say, "Baby up. God, I thank you for carrying me. I don't see a way, but I know you control the universe. You're my provider, my protector, my deliverer, my way maker." The fact is, God is carrying you right now. But if you don't recognize it, you'll live stressed out, upset. No, you're in your Father's arms. He's holding you tightly. Nothing can snatch you away. Isaiah 40 says, He carries you close to His heart. You're not way out there in the distance, just one of the billions of people on earth. God has you close to His heart. You're His most prized possession. There's nothing more valuable to God than you. The scripture says, God knows when a sparrow falls to the ground, a little bird. How much more is God concerned about you? And as much as you love your children, multiply that by billions of times. That's how much God loves you. He's been carrying you since you were born. He's going to continue to carry you till you breathe your last breath. You may have things coming against you, but God wouldn't have allowed it if it was going to stop you. Come back to that place of peace, that place of trust. Father, thank you that you're carrying me, that I have grace for this season, strength for this day, the favor to move forward. During those 40 years that the Israelites wandered in the desert, at times they got off course and started worshiping idols. They made gods out of stone, these large statues, gods out of gold and silver. As they traveled, they had to carry these gods around. They were heavy, was a burden. They struggled to make sure to take care of them. What's interesting is they were carrying their gods instead of letting God carry them. We may not make stone idols today, but sometimes we're carrying burdens, weighed down by trouble, living worried, trying to fix it all in our own strength. In a sense, you're carrying your God. Why don't you let God carry you? The scripture says, cast your burdens on the Lord. Release the weight of it, and He will sustain you. If you'll release the burden, quit trying to figure it all out, losing sleep, letting your mind work overtime, then God will carry you. But as long as you're carrying it, God will step back. He wants us to depend on Him. It's very powerful to say, God, I need you. I trust you. I know you're in control. I believe that you've got this, so I'm gonna live this day in faith, knowing that you are carrying me. I hope you enjoyed watching this clip. You can watch the full message here on our YouTube channel. We'd love to hear your prayer request and how the ministry has impacted your life. You can leave a comment below. Make sure to subscribe to our channel to stay inspired all throughout the week. We'll see you next time.